Melody Salesforce Flowsome.
Hello, Flowsome people. Welcome to the Salesforce Flowsome channel. In this video, we will quickly explain what a loop is and how to use the loop element in Flow. So first, let's start with loop in programming. A loop is to run the same actions for several times. We call each time an iteration. In general, a loop structure has three parts: start condition, current item, and actions. Start condition is to evaluate if the system should start a new iteration. If yes, the current item is to tell the system which target we should run the actions on. And then finally, the actions are the things that actually happen. An iteration is then considered finished. After that, the system will go back to the start condition again to see if the next iteration should start. If not, the whole loop will end. So let's look at a quick example. Imagine you're a cashier and there are 5 customers waiting in line. The start condition is whether there are more customers that need to pay. If yes, the current item is the first customer that hasn't paid yet, and the action is to help them check out. You will continue doing so until the start condition is not met anymore, which is when there are no customers. Then you break this loop and go home. There are 5 iterations in this loop in total. So enough with fun examples. Let's move on to the loop element in Flow. Once you're familiar with the loop concept, the loop element is extremely easy. So let's drag a loop element onto the canvas. After you specify the label and the API name, the first thing is to select collection variable. The loop element in Flow can only do one thing, which is to loop through a collection variable. So let's click on the lookup and then fill in our collection variable. This element controls 2 parts, the start condition and the current item. The start condition is whether there are more items in the collection that we need to run the actions on, and the current item is the first item that hasn't been executed yet. Then we can see the second thing, direction. You can either choose to start from the beginning or start from the end. So after the element, you will define the following actions. So I will put an email action and an update records. So how you can connect the loop element with other elements is you can simply drag from the loop element. Then you will see 2 options. One is for each item in the collection, and the other one is after the last item in the collection. So when you choose the first one, this action will execute inside that iteration. So let's say if you have 10 iterations, the actions will run 10 times, once per item. And then you have the second connector, which is after the last item, which means that once your loop is finished, you want to continue your flow. A very important note here is, always remember to link the last element in the iteration back to the loop element so that the system will know it needs to evaluate for the next iteration. Then, an advanced topic is the loop element is not the only loop you can have in Flow. So let's look at the structure again. You can actually use a decision element to check the start condition, and then use an assignment element to define the current item. Then there you have a custom loop. A great method is to use a number variable called counter to define these factors. If you're interested, check out my counter article in the description. Lastly, let's summarize when you should use loop. First ask, am I going to run the same actions many times? If yes, you will probably need a loop. Then ask, do I have a collection and I need to run the actions on each item? If yes, use the loop element. Otherwise, design a custom loop. That's it for loop and loop element. If you enjoyed this video, like, subscribe, and turn on notification. Salesforce Flowsome, thank you for watching.